Very good morning to all. Today we are making bread rolls with all the stages to be followed while making them, for which the requirements are as follows. Refined flour 200 grams, dry activated yeast 10 grams, butter for lamination 15 grams, sugar 15 grams which acts as a food for the yeast, and salt 5 grams. And we are using normal lukewarm water to knead the dough. Now we are going to make flying ferment, for which we are going to add yeast, then sugar, which is food for the yeast, and lukewarm water. Now this is not as required by the recipe, but a little, which will definitely go all complete content in the recipe. We'll keep this aside so that yeast will make a fizz which will leave CO2, and then we'll add it to our flour. We'll start the process, for which we are going to sieve the flour first. Nicely, so that it takes aeration. If you are adding raising agent to it, you have to sieve it at least 3 times so that raising agent disperses throughout evenly. Make a well. Salt. And then we'll go in with the flying ferment that we have made. This recipe will take nearly 60%, 55 to 60% of the water. Now we have taken 200 grams of flour, so 120 ml of water is going to be absorbed by the flour. Okay, here we are going to start kneading the dough first. You play your fingers within the circle so that the flying ferment is converted into a paste, so that the water does not run here and there. Beautiful. Now it is converting into paste. And the salt which we have added is also getting dissolved. Take a little flour inside, and so on. And you go on making it into a dough. You're going to make a soft pliable dough out of it by using the required amount of water, which is kept besides. I'll just take a dough scraper to show you how to handle. Now this is a scraper. This is the way you should always use it, so that you collect the ingredient to the center again. Put it down. Put it down and go on making the video. Till it is banded together into a soft pliable dough. Okay, now you can see the dough has been formed into one lump. Here we are going to add our butter, which is a soft one. Cream it a little. And laminate the dough in it. Now this is going to help laminate the flour cells so that after baking, your crumb opens. And you will have a light, spongy bread. Incorporate complete fat into it. And then let it rest for first proofing. Give it a good friction so that it will incorporate complete fat and dough will not be sticky anymore. As you go on doing this, the stage will definitely rise. Correct? Now this is the stage that you will have, and with two hands how you use, to and fro, let it go up, pull back, up, back, up, back, so that the complete dough has been fidgeted, not only one side. This is what you have. Couple of pans will give you a beautiful smooth surface on the top without any cracks. Now this is what you should have. Now this will go for roasting for nearly 40 minutes. That is first proofing that will make it go across. I've dusted the bowl a little. I drop it in. I'm going to dampen the duster and cover it with a wet cloth. Okay, now we have proven it, that is called first proofing, for nearly 35 to 40 minutes. Now it has risen nicely, you can see that the impression goes down, it does not springs back, therefore it is nicely puffed. So this is again for the same reason, knockback. So that if somewhere the yeast has remained a little more, it should mix throughout. The dough, the stage that we were at. Beautiful. Now we will see how much it weighs. We have taken 200 grams of flour and how much water goes into it, this will be telling us. 366 grams approximately. means 160 ml of water, in which we have added fat also, yeast, then sugar. These things are there. Okay, so the dough is 360 grams. So I'm going to divide them into rolls of 45 grams. So I'll make 8 rolls approximately. So I cut, I weigh 45. Okay, so I have divided that dough into 8 rolls. We are going to make a simple bread roll today. Dust a little flour, take this dough, and you make a good surface round ball out of it without any cracks on it. Now people will play on the table, on the hands, with both the hands, and here we place it in the Yeah, these are simple bread rolls. You must have seen various types of knots coming into picture. Same dough has been used over there, and the chef shows his skills in shaping it differently with different knots. But today we are making a simple one. Now this is a lined tray of bread rolls, which we are going to place it for second proofing now, again for 40 to 45 minutes, covering it with a damp cloth as we did for the first time. This goes for proofing. Okay, now we have proven this bread rolls for nearly 45 minutes. Yeah, and this is how it looks. You can give an impression over here. It does not spring back, that means it is done. Now this, you can apply an egg wash or milk wash and then put it in deck at 190 degrees approximately for 10 to 15 minutes. To examine the bread roll, pick it up, it should be light enough. Knock it, it should feel hollow. When it cools down completely, cut it with a bread knife, and the open crumb, if you see a porous crumb, that is a beautiful bread for you. That is how it should be. A good characteristic of a bread. Enjoy.